Hi, let's talk about the cardiac veins. In this video, we'll discuss the venous drainage of the heart. So the cardiac veins are of two systems. There is the greater system, which is the bulk of drainage from the heart, and the smaller system. The greater system is what drains most of the myocardium. And most of the myocardium is what we would refer to as the subepicardium myocardium. So that's nearly full thickness of the myocardium. All of this greater system is draining into the right atrium by means of a coronary sinus. That coronary sinus, which is here, occupies the coronary sulcus in between the diaphragmatic surface of the heart and the base of the heart, and it's fed by several tributaries. The first being the great cardiac vein. The great cardiac vein occupies the anterior interventricular sulcus, paired up with the anterior interventricular branch. It's usually superficial to the anterior interventricular branch. And it wraps around in that coronary sulcus to drain directly into the coronary sinus. There's also the middle cardiac vein. The middle cardiac vein is found within the posterior interventricular sulcus, superficial to the posterior interventricular branch, and that also drains directly into the coronary sinus. The next major tributary is the small cardiac vein. The small cardiac vein follows along the inferior border of the heart, usually superficial to the right marginal branch. And then it wraps around in the coronary sulcus to feed into the coronary sinus. So the three major tributaries of the coronary sinus include the great cardiac vein from the anterior interventricular sulcus, the middle cardiac vein from the posterior interventricular sulcus, and the small cardiac vein from the inferior border of the heart. That coronary sinus is draining into the right atrium, just adjacent to the AV node of the heart. There are also anterior cardiac veins. These anterior cardiac veins are quite unique in that they're draining the wall of the right ventricle, but they don't feed typically into the coronary sinus. They can from time to time feed into the small cardiac vein, but usually they drain independently into the right atrium. And upon dissection, you can usually identify these because they're bridging over the RCA within the coronary sulcus. The smaller system consists of small cardiac veins, sometimes called Thebsian veins, after Adam Christian Thebsius, which was a German anatomist. These small cardiac veins drain the subendocardial myocardium. So we're talking about this region of the myocardium. And they drain directly into whichever chamber they are adjacent to. So they are at their greatest density, curiously enough, around the right atrium. They are at their least density around the left ventricle. But all of these small cardiac veins drain into the chambers of which the myocardium is going to surround. More at the right atrium, less at the left ventricle. So we've discussed the greater and the smaller system of cardiac veins, and how the greater system consists of a coronary sinus draining into the right atrium with great, middle, and small cardiac vein tributaries and anterior cardiac veins that drain directly into the right atrium. There are also small cardiac veins or Thebsian veins of the smaller system that drain directly into the chambers of which they're adjacent. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.